After reactivating the water pumps and helping a zombie beekeeper, the protectors of the pass made their way up to the banquet hall near the top of the castle. There they met the king named Gorquith, who had been magically reduced to an ochre jelly. He shared that he and his nobles were killed by Coltung, executed for their rebellion. However, the Inquisitor Griot deemed the fate not becoming of the king and instead pushed him into the awaiting jelly. Using their scroll of resurrection, Bryn successfully revived the king. He rewarded the friends with the passcode to work the elevator leading up to the top levels of the castle. And as the party left, the king implored the party to kill Coltung for him and his nobles. Also, Winry and Jack decided they were going to date.
Also, yeah, Bryn grabbed
completely
the bolt.
Bypassed
totally
that, apparently.
About it. Yeah. I was trying to, whenever I do these, yeah. I try to only keep the plot Dude. Points in, not the...
I mean, that's kind of a plot
stuff.
Point.
Yeah, the romantic,
point.
The romantic
yeah,
stuff.
I feel like our listeners are not going to quit because you just dropped that like it was nothing.
All or what?
Listeners. All five of them.
They're going to hear
five
it.
Is, before five is generous.
Oh, well, you're right.
It is not. We get an average of 65 views per episode.
So minus five from all of you.
65.
I don't usually watch them.
I don't usually
either. I've been slowly catching up.
I did watch the live one because, you know, had to. But
yep.
So that's done.
So are we starting this
so
off?
The end,
oh, Justin, yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, let me. I'll lead us in a little bit nicer. Jack and Winry had gone off talking. Though not physically talking, as they were talking mentally with a psychic
making
connection.
Out.
yeah,
more,
talking physically.
More physical communication.
While the rest of you had set up in the lift, Bryn had cast a hut in the lift in order to stay in. And while you guys were in there, I hadn't really talked about it at the time because we were kind of a little rushed to get to the end there. But the Clan Malorn people were going to come back and meet you at the lift to stay, if you recall that they'd mentioned that they were going to stay with you at the lift. So after about, you know, 15 minutes, something like this, of them exploring the other side, regaling back that there was little to find over there, just for your information.
Of course they said
they do come back and head into the lift to meet with you guys. In the meantime, Jack Winry went off to talk and then have come back since then, holding hands on their way back into the hut.
There ain't space for all of them in my hut, so they're right outside the door.
They're all small.
They probably have their own.
Y'all gonna fit in here?
Get stack on each other's shoulders or something?
What if I don't let them in?
Justin moved into the corner. that would have made things anyway.
Did they?
That's fine. If you really want to kick them out, they can stay in the hallway.
Yeah,
and feel a little put out, and they say, "Fine, we'll go find our own place then. We will. We'll be back." After a rest, how about that?
We're just used to having our own space, and we all know where we go in the hut.
How many of them are there?
Does it say that it's limited to
nine? Is my mic not working right now?
Nine creatures of medium size or smaller. So sorry, you just don't.
It's working.
Okay.
We hear you.
Can I ask a question? Do I have to raise my freaking hand?
We're back.
Did they?
Ryan has to relocate to Michigan just because he can't talk in D&D.
Buddy!
Did they independently find the code?
No.
So they don't know that.
Do we believe them when they say they did not independently find the code?
You can make an insight check if you'd like to. What I would probably say, Steph, for the nine creatures of medium size or smaller, is... That's fine. I'm really not freaking out about it. They also can sleep like in a pile on the side for all I care.
That's how halflings sleep, is they just pile on top of each other.
It isn't saying that you're limited to nine, like by the magic. You're limited to nine by space, effectively.
No, we need lots of space to sleep. We're very twitchy sleepers.
Okay. They will go find their own place to sleep.
Oh no.
Actually, you know what? We found a nice little hallway that we can make use of. We will head over there instead.
It's like they knock on the dome and like
it's nothing personal, but Bryn snores.
It feels pretty personal.
Well, it's okay.
Are you I don't feel
that.
17, Justin.
It seems like they're being truthful that they don't know what the code is.
Cool. One other thing. Jack. You know, you hook me up with maybe a little bit of that, you know, lightness feeling. I'm going to do a little bit of whittling, and it always helps me calm my nerves.
Are you?
Of course. I'm gonna cast Enhance Ability, but I'm gonna
do
give Embarrass Endurance instead.
Yes,
Constitution goes way up. But he's not gonna know. I'll be like, "Yep, here you go."
I love it.
No, I'm sorry. I'll give you Bull's Strength. So like,
you accidentally break it in your whittling.
Oh wait, you're right. That's not funny. That's not funny. That would be mean. That would
just
be mean.
Accidentally cut straight through it.
Oh my god.
I'm like,
no,
buddy.
I'm gonna do fox. No, I'm gonna do fox's cunning, so your intelligence kind of goes up, so you see like all the mistakes that you've made and like feel self conscious about it a little.
Oh,
no.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, I think it's gonna feel pretty different.
He'll at least be really intelligent enough now to notice that there is a difference.
Yeah, right.
I think I've been tricked.
You say that out loud.
You are suspicious, at least I would say.
So I essentially like place my hand on you to cast the magic, and you feel it hit your body, and you look back at me and go, "I feel like I've been tricked."
Yeah. Listen.
I'm just kidding you, buddy.
Here, bud.
I'm just kidding you, bud. I'll tap him and do the right one.
Thanks.
The other one releases as well.
Do we still have our telepathic bond?
At least for a little while. I don't think you were probably gone for an hour.
I'll say you're a good friend to him.
I try to be. I like to think we're friends.
Ryan's shit-eating grin over there.
Meanwhile, I'm like kind of shaking it out a little bit. And then I go to whittling.
Getting back used to dumber you.
Yeah. I didn't like being that smart.
Well,
you still see
the other one go away
in your whittling project.
Yes. The other one does go away.
Yeah, I can't stack those. Excuse me. There it is. I made it all the way through the recap, guys.
Wow.
And now we get two in a row.
Lucky
so,
us.
Assuming we're all kind of like settling down for the night, after Winry and I come in, I imagine that, I don't know, if Cassie, will we like sleep closer to each other? You know, we probably
I will lay down and then
before.
I will leave it up to you because I'm soft and warm.
No, I feel like I've said before that I snuggle up to you when we're in the dome, so probably it's normal.
Listeners can confirm or deny this in the future.
All right, I'm pretty sure, but maybe not.
And
everyone kind of settles down a little
bit.
Go ahead.
I don't know, mine's long.
Mine might be long too, so go ahead.
I'll start messing with my hand wrapped in. I've been experimenting with the living weapon, and I know it doesn't speak to me like other people's, but the way it moves around my body, it feels alive.
Are you just telling this to Jack or everybody?
Everyone.
Oh. Well, it is called a living weapon. You might be feeling some kind of sentience.
It can do different things. And I want to show you what it can do in practice hitting a real target. But I know once I start using it this way, I'm going to lose other abilities.
Interesting.
Do you feel like you have a choice?
Yes.
You need a moving living target?
I do. But right. Once I start using this way, I'm not going to be able to cast spells.
Oh.
Well, I guess just logically, so the spell that I remember being most useful is when you make the ground all sludgy and everything and sort of trap people in that bubble. And while very helpful, Jack kind of does that too.
You've also done, I think you've also done Cone of Cold out of it, hadn't you?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I have a few cold moves.
Maybe it's not
that were supposed to be lightning.
And you always had Beam of Frost? Frost Beam?
Ray.
I can't remember the name of it.
Ray of Frost?
Ray of Frost, that's it. And that always slowed people down.
If you can't do all of the crazy stuff with the snow and the frost, will that, I don't know, make you homesick or something?
No.
Very thoughtful of you,
Brad. I was. I started doing these cold spells. Only one person.
I'm a thoughtful guy.
Punch him in the arm.
When I got rejected from the monastery, and I think I was trying to fit in, even though I couldn't do the spells exactly like they could, I could still do them cold. But I worked to get away from my parents and be more myself and to accept myself, find people who accepted and loved me. And I don't think I need to do the cold spells anymore because I was just trying to fit in.
If you feel drawn, Winry, to exploring more into what the living weapon does, then I don't think that you should let your past hold you back. That's the direction you wish to go in. No matter how beneficial others may think your spells could be.
Take out the apple pie crust and try to break it.
Crumble it between your fingers.
Very hard.
Between your paws.
So I need a volunteer from the audience.
Sure, yeah. I'd like to see you try. Oh. If you can't hit me, then what happens then?
I'll try to hit you again.
Oh, okay. Well, let's see your best shot.
Maybe try to get hit.
Oh no, I'm not going to make this easy.
How big is the hut?
10-foot radius, so 20-foot wide.
Maybe we should take this.
I'll
go to the
opposite. I think I still have some healing too. So I mean,
there's a bunch of pillows and roll mats.
And we're about to go to sleep.
I wouldn't want to break a pillow and have feathers go everywhere, you know.
Also, Winry, I want to say while I'm amazed by your current abilities, I wouldn't want you to hold back learning something new just for us. If you think this is more beneficial for us, we trust you.
But also, you are with the spells or without, and we will feel the same about you either way. We just want you to be happy.
And besides, you might not hit me, and then you're just going to be stuck the way you are, so.
Man, now I wish I had slow
prepared. Well, let's do it. I will walk up to him, 5 feet from him, and then I will walk back 5, 10, 15, 20. Can't go any farther, can I? And then I'm going to punch him.
What?
So she throws her fist outwards, and the weapon, it used to just be like a bangle, like a hand wrap, basically. But as she thrusts the fist forward, it like uncurls from her hand and flares out towards Rev on the far side of the hut. Go ahead and roll the attack.
Wow.
She's like last girl or something.
One.
Still learning, however. The first strike, Rev doesn't even get a chance to move, actually. He's like frozen in place, but the strike goes like right over his shoulder and smacks on the wall to the side. And even though he didn't hit him or like he didn't dodge, he looks over at it like, the heck just happened? As it like zoom shoots back to her and like wraps back around her arm and she collects it again.
That was amazing.
See what I mean?
You're gonna be so dangerous. You can move so fast and now hit so far. How far can it go? Do you know?
It can only go an extra 5 feet normally, and then I could add 2 points, add energy to make it go farther.
Wow.
Well, I think you've demonstrated your new fascinating abilities, and you didn't hit me, so let's just call it a night.
That meant.
I think you should try it again, Winry.
I think you should try it again, Winry.
I'm sure Rev will be okay with it.
Wait a second, maybe if we...
He volunteered once, I'm sure he'll be fine with it.
What if I miss again?
You won't miss. The first one was practice. Give it a shot.
Yes.
Come on, Rev, you can take it.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. Maybe just call it a night since she's obviously very talented.
Oh, 16.
Oh, okay. 16 total?
Oh, I'm still uh-huh. talking as
yes. I don't know about this.
I don't know about that. Oh, maybe it's I don't know. Where does it hit me? I got people. We're gonna take a vote.
Did it hit you?
I'm at armor class is 15. I don't know why I volunteered to do this. Pretty stupid of me, honestly.
You wanted to see me try. I'm going to hit you not in your bad leg that was bad, but the other leg, like your thigh, nice and
so you can have meaty. Two mediocre legs.
You're missing an opportunity legs. To a do a nut meaty. Shot, but
yeah, right.
It's still close enough that it makes Rev like seize up a little bit. Like,
that's what the natural error. One was the nut shot.
10 damage.
Whoa.
It hits a little harder too, not that it did right now.
Yeah. Not that it did right now.
So to kind of...
Okay. All right, that was awesome.
It's like the demonstration was weak, but Rev got hurt, so we're all like, yay!
So to kind of pull this back, so to speak, to more game terms, just so everyone is aware, didn't really realize it until... very recently, but there was a monk subclass called the Way of the Living Weapon.
Oh, really?
And it just like, so it was cool. One of those things where it's just like, it feels right.
There are other ones that I was thinking about. I didn't like having to save key points for spells or have to think about spells. I think totally. I was trying to be sort of like Scarlet because I didn't want to give up spells completely. But I was.
I mean, that's what I did with my armor. I didn't want to have a disadvantage at stealth.
So this subclass is technically an Eberron subclass written by Keith Baker, the maker of Eberron.
Oh, wow.
We know who Keith Baker is.
I didn't.
Justin.
You're not me.
So it has Keith some Baker. Feel of Eberron at times that we're kind of repurposing a little bit. but if you wanted to look it up, you can find it somewhere if you wanted to, or you can just kind of experience it through Winry. Either way.
That's very cool. That's
really
cool.
Justin told me to look it up.
That was mostly aimed at Rob and Becca.
Yeah. Oh, don't worry. I'm going to look it up.
I'm going to.
I love it. Well, cool. Well, if this makes you happy, Winry, you have all of our support, I assume. You have my support.
Thank you. And I know you have the spells handled.
Right. I do have a lot of those. That sounded sarcastic, but I do have a lot of spells.
I'll go and sit by Rev and jokingly give him a shoulder and say, "You okay?" But with that, do healing word too.
Yeah, it hurts. It hurts right here. A little
bit. What are you pointing towards? What are you pointing towards? It's the same from our view. It looks like you're pointing towards your tush.
Just kidding. No.
I assume he points to his leg, keeping this out of the gutter. And then with that, I'll pretend to massage, but massage it a little too hard too, making it try to hurt more while also healing him.
Thanks for clarifying.
You guys are terrible. I'm supposed to be the bad one. Come on, guys. All right.
Well.
Okay. I'm good. I think. Feeling a little awkward about it.
And I feel like that was Ryan and not Rev.
No, I think that actually is Rev too.
But yeah, I think it is.
Be honest.
I think it checks out. Well, after all that calms down and people start going to sleep, and Mathari and I start our transes, I'm going
to
kind of like.
Time.
Yeah. So I'll volunteer to do the first one.
I usually do the first one, but if you want to take the first one, I'll let you.
Yeah, I'll do the first one. So as everyone's kind of like curling up to go to sleep and Mathari is going into her trance, I am going to summon Parallax and I'm going to lay him on my lap. And telepathically, just to him, I'm going to make sure I wait until my connection with Winry fades.
Sure. Okay.
So cross streams.
Yeah.
Cross.
Get off this line, Winry. I'm talking to my friend.
The internet starts connecting. That's an old person joke, Becca.
I got it.
I got it.
I will summon Parallax and lay him out on my lap and telepathically say to him, "Well, we're not in combat anymore and we're alone. So I think it's time to spill the beans, Parallax. What are you? Who are you? How do I have these powers? Let's talk."
"I am the remnant of a creature. I am the power..."
You need to write this down. I can't write.
Can't. He just had me sign a check for him.
You wanted to have this conversation with a...
I didn't think about it. I forgot that I need to write notes. Okay. Sorry. You're a remnant of a creature.
Remnant of a creature. The power left over... or at least the majority of it.
Do you remember what the creature was?
I do. Haven't been informing because I didn't want to influence your decision making.
Well, I would say we're pretty well bound together at this point, so let's hear it. Well, if it's something dumb, I won't judge you.
You might say that I was dumb once. At least that I made a rather large mistake. You see, I trusted. And by trusting, I was betrayed. I was betrayed by another of my stature. Another creature of power. One who helps form the world. You know, you should really have tried some wind or lightning powers at some point. I think you could find the experience to be quite enjoyable. But I lost my heart. And it is only through, hopefully you, but someone physical, that I might regain my body.
Do you know where your body is?
I do not, unfortunately. I don't have all the memories of my past life. Just of who I was, and who I should become again.
You said that the creature you were from, it sounded like you said form the world. Are you saying that the creature that you were was a god?
You'd speak of it that way, perhaps. An elemental pillar. You might have heard me, though not in this form. This is but a mere sliver of my prior power. You might have heard it called Avalona.
I've heard
perhaps
that name before.
More specifically, the Storm Chaser Eagle.
Whoa!
Justin dropping truth bombs!
Holy shit. I think I say that. Holy shit!
Don't worry, I'm not the kind of deity that is unhappy with words.
Kirsten.
Wow.
Do not have the full power that I once had. I will let you know that now. But I do have a substantial portion, at least. But no way to make it manifest without you.
What can I do to help?
For now, prove that you are the right one to do what needs to be done. That is all. I know it's vague. I know it's potentially concerning, but I do not require overt displays. I do not require any sacrifices. All I need is for you to become the one that reunites me with my heart.
Well, I will admit, I'm really pleased that you're not a demon. Little worried about that. And if you need my help, I'll do what I can. And as I say that, do I believe what Parallax is saying?
You can make an insight check if you'd like to.
Do you need help picking up your dice, baby?
So my phone doesn't recognize me anymore. So I have to wait an extra second for it to register.
Because it was your thumbprint?
No.
Oh, it's your face. Oh.
My face, yeah.
But also
thumbprint's
funny.
Really funny, though.
Yeah.
24 total. I rolled a natural 16.
You have no reason not to.
Yeah. Well, I appreciate you being forthright, and I'd be happy to help in any way that I can, and also will definitely give a lightning spell a try, or a wind. And for what it's worth, I'm glad you're on my side, and I'm glad that you're here to help me protect my friends and end this war. Think we make a good team.
I will try not to be too demanding. Onerous in my demands.
Well, we're a partnership now, so we'll see what we can do. But I'm happy to help.
The voice goes dormant in your head.
Yeah, I don't think I have anything else. I will dismiss him. And I assume that kind of everyone just got to sleep. And I will, I'll dismiss him and I'll kind of turn around and see everyone's asleep. And I'll go, everyone! Parallax is part of the Storm Chaser Eagle!
Why are you screaming?
Jack.
I just asked him, he told me.
Jack, I'm not
gonna. I have my sword drawn.
Yeah, right.
Did you have to yo?
Well, first of all, he's not a demon, which is awesome. I know everyone was at least thinking it for a second. No, they can't hear us. It's fine.
It doesn't matter. I can hear you.
Well, you should. That's why I got everyone up. I feel like none of you are taking this the right way. He's a piece of... It's the Storm Chaser Eagle, right?
Storm Chaser, yep.
Yeah, do I know who that is?
He's a piece of the Storm Chaser Eagle.
From the legends.
Yeah, from the creation myth. We all know who the Storm Chaser Eagle is.
What if he's just a demon lying to you?
Yeah, I don't think that's what he is.
It sounds like he's just messing with
what
you.
What does he want with you?
He said that he wants to reunite with his body. That he's maybe even the heart of the Storm Chaser Eagle, and that he wants to reconnect.
Yeah, man.
It definitely sounds like he's talking with you. It does sound like that,
well,
but how can
let
we
me just say
his body even exists anymore?
If I was talking with you.
Well, I didn't get that vibe, all right? I'm decent at reading people, and even if he's a sword and it was just a voice in my head, all right, now this is sounding more suspicious as I say it out loud. Anyway, I don't think that's the case, but I'll take it under advisement. Go back to sleep, all of you. You did not have the correct reaction, and I would like you all to go back to sleep. Thank you.
You cross
Thank
with
you
us.
For
We're
telling
the ones who are supposed to be cross with you.
Shh. Go to sleep. You're welcome, Winry.
Rev
was already asleep before you even were done.
Thanks for writing that down.
10 minutes goes by and Bryn is still tossing and turning and huffing.
Oh no.
I will pull out my banjo and I will go sit next to her and very lightly play her a lullaby until she goes to sleep.
I like that.
Well, with that finished, unless anyone else has more stuff to do tonight.
Longest night.
Yeah. Anybody else? You want to send some messages real quick? Or?
I don't know if I can hear that. Oh, I did because I got
How's Charlotta doing? Or Shalosha doing?
Shalosha.
Shashasha. Shashasha.
Just kidding. Don't. Yeah.
Don't. Please don't.
I'm not planning on it. Trust me.
Long rest time?
Long rest. Go ahead and take the long rest. We are leveling up to 12 just for everyone, for viewers' sake, to understand. And as you do so, Myetharia, I'd actually like for you to make a perception check for me.
Oh, what our hit dice do? Do they automatically do it?
Yeah.
Yes, definitely. You should get half your hit dice back.
Ooh, eeny, meeny, miny, mo.
Damn it, Justin.
What?
All right.
I don't think I have 17. Any lightning or wind spells.
You might not.
17 for me. 17.
As everyone else is just getting to the point of waking up, your shift just about done, Myetharia. You are listening, because the door is closed and all. at least presumably. I don't know. Maybe you didn't close the door. Either way. And you're listening. And you didn't notice at first, or at least right away, but some of the white noise is missing. It takes a moment to realize. The water noise has stopped. That sound of slowly filling and building pressure. It's no longer filling.
Can we see the Clan Malorn from where we are?
Or no, are you told like, them to leave.
Okay. okay, then I'll... Are the others kind of up and stirring?
Just, yeah, this was at the end of your long rest is when you noticed and realized it.
And I'll definitely say something, just... You guys hear that?
Water stopped. We don't hear it.
Water stopped.
Yeah, you actually hear the absence of noise.
I said it that way because it was funny. Thanks, guys.
Well, it sounds like it's time to go.
I hope that's all it is.
Maybe the pressure is built?
That's what I'm hoping, but obviously I don't think any of us understand this system well enough to know if it's a good sign or a bad sign.
Well, let's go out there and check it out, huh?
Right.
Indeed.
Oh, teleport.
Do it. What?
So we're done with our long rest then, right?
Yes.
Justin?
Yes.
Okay, yes. So we're out and the hut. What happens to the hut? Does it just kind of...
Does it
go in and like implode, or does it explode in a puff?
Well, the way does she it described go... it going up, I would think that it like unravels the shadows from the top, kind of like peeling back to the bottom.
Like an onion. Very nice. I like it.
Or like a mist blowing away.
That wants to leave it an onion.
I mean, how would you feel about me swapping out
bright meteors for lightning bolt?
Sure, that's fine.
It would be technically my untrained for my level up.
That's fine. If that's what you want to do.
I want to try. Yeah. Technically, I would have heard that before I leveled up, so I would have been able to make that determination. I'm going to do it. Okay. Wait. Well, I guess we should go check it out.
Okay, with Clan.
Everyone
Malorn.
Ready? Well, I doubt it was them. I mean, I wouldn't imagine they would.
No, but see if they're ready.
Sure.
I'm unprepared.
I mean.
So what's happening?
Yeah,
nothing.
I thought Jack had some ideas. I'm just surprised that Jack is not speaking up right now.
Sorry,
Rob, maybe Rob was the one who edited.
I'm not sure. The only way that the water would stop is if someone was stopping the wheel, and the only people that are really left down here are Clan Malorn.
No,
maybe not
that we know of.
No. The water is building up pressure, so it stopped running because all of the systems are now engaged. So it's a hydraulic system, which means we're not going to hear rushing water until we turn something on and we hear the pressure of the water going in. So, right, Justin, I mean, I'm assuming we know how the system works. That's certainly
one interpretation of it, yeah.
Or the water got blocked.
Okay.
Then I just want to say, guys, I didn't suck picking spells, guys. I'm so excited.
Till we get into a fight, and then
yeah, then yeah, it's, all right. Then
well, yeah. Then well, there's one way to test the theory. Let's we start try the lift.
Start this bad boy up. We have the code, right?
We do. Everybody ready?
Are we going to just do that without checking in with Clan Malone? I mean, I'm fine either way. I just want to know what everyone's thinking.
Oh, they'll be fine.
Oh, I did want to do that in game. I think I'm kind of glad that we're going to try it now if it works, because I don't think we should bring Clan Malone with us upstairs. I think they're just going to be a liability rather than an assist.
Shouldn't we talk to them about that, though?
Yeah, but, you know, we could accidentally test the lift and it goes up and we were too scared to go back down because we didn't know the go back down code.
If you want to deal with it, it's better to ask forgiveness rather than permission.
It's not quite
that's the
Winry
I know.
The phrase isn't quite, it's better, but
sure. Easier, not better.
Well,
I would say let's do it. Let's pull the lever.
Righty.
Crunk. Pull the lever, crunk.
Okay, sounds like everyone agrees. Pull the lever, crunk.
Okay. So who's at the controls?
Definitely Jack.
Okay. Walking over, everyone on the lift, Jack moves over to the controls, and as he does so, pulling the lever down to the first location.
D.
The water pressure is enough that the doors slam shut first, as a lift would. It starts to raise, but something feels wrong. And after a few seconds of kind of a stuttering, jerking raise, it gives out and slumps back to the ground again.
I knew it.
The door then
wrong.
Swings back open. From like slides back to the top open once more as the lift comes to a rest at the bottom. Something has happened.
Water again?
Out of curiosity, how heavy is this lift?
Heavy. Like, it's a 20 foot square of stone with all workings underneath it. I would think a few thousand pounds at least.
Let's go check out that water wheel.
It shouldn't be too heavy to lift us. It should be strong enough. I'm worried that there's something off.
All right, so we go over there. Let's go over there.
Okay. Walking out the door, you're met by a group of halflings.
Hi!
Looking at the doorway from the far side of the hallway that you enter into, with looks of anger, distrust, and hurt.
You're giving it
That's a lot of emotions to convey with eyes.
We're giving it a test. That's the go-to now.
Something strange that we heard with the water, and so we thought we would give it a shot. Didn't work, so we're gonna go check the water supply.
Huh. Okay. Well, if you don't mind, we're gonna stay here in the lift. You know, just in case another test happens.
You wouldn't happen to know what's wrong with the lift, would you?
No, as far as I know, it's still where you said you fixed it.
Do I believe her?
Yeah, make an insight check.
23.
She seems surprised that it didn't work.
Interesting.
If you don't mind, and she kind of leads her parade of halflings behind her into the lift. The far side, and they kind of settle down in locations and begin to cook themselves breakfast, it appears, as they came running across from where they were sleeping when they heard the lift start going.
By all means, you can be the first ones into the mouth of danger, of course. That's what you'd like.
Well, sausages, like, okay, sounds good.
While you guys have breakfast, we'll go and continue to do the work. We'll be back.
Stereo.
right, let's check out this room with the...
That, wow, look at down. Look at Ryan remembering the right way to go and everything. But there, I'm going to bring it back to here, as we'll have everybody else kind of trailing behind.
Is this the right way?
This
if
way.
We were at, we had a different map to look at.
I just need to stop because I'm picking spells now based on what we're doing.
Yeah, so quit.
So head in this direction.
Roll 20 didn't like anything. My roll 20 did not like that, whatever just happened.
He moved our characters.
I did yank you guys around a little bit.
Where are we?
So this is the hallway leading back towards the water pump that Rev was leading you guys towards. And as Rev comes around that corner, looking down towards the end of the hallway, he has a moment of... As at the end of the hallway, he sees a handful of skeletal beings, a couple of whom are kind of beating on the water wheel and the pump at the far side of the room.
Oh, come on.
They don't seem to have noticed you yet, but there are definitely clangs from the distance.
Come on, knock it off.
Stephanie asks if they look like the ones we fought before.
They look pretty similar, at least, in terms of being, you know, the black, flamey-eyed skeletal beings.
Ah. I guess we had to move the bodies out of the room, huh? I'm gonna pick up my
humorously,
cross...
If you look really closely, you can still actually see the dead bodies on the ground as well.
Oh, then never mind. Okay. Well, then I'm going to fire a crossbow bolt at it.
Okay, sure. Go ahead. And I will then change music, and we will roll initiative.
What the fuck?
I'm going to use precision. And just...
And I remember from fighting these ones just got turnt. They didn't explode, right?
16 to hit.
Explode?
Or they didn't.
They didn't immediately die when they got turned.
Oh, correct.
She's asking about the challenge rating.
Yes, they did not just
immediately.
But
did my challenge rating change?
Ah.
All right, 16 to hit.
Who rolled an insight about Clan Malorn?
You.
You know about about knowing. The
code?
Combination.
Me. Rev.
It was 17. It was around the same time that you guys got
interrupted. That's metagaming right there. What was the roll? How well do you think you did on that roll?
No, that wasn't what I was asking.
I mean, that was what Ryan said. Well, anyway.
It's more like this. Of course you didn't hear what the number was because all of you guys were talking over me at the same time.
Right? Oh.
All right,
that's
metagaming.
Fair.
Listen, what happened, Ryan, was you now have had the experience of not being cut off and playing live, and now you're just getting back into what we normally do.
Yeah, I guess so.
All the pain and frustration that is being cut off by everyone
Sorry,
else.
Sorry, Ryan.
Let's see, Winry rolled a 14, Rev a 12. What was your attack, Rev?
Oh, it was 16.
Okay. You can actually roll with advantage because if you want to, because you would have.
What'd you roll?
They don't know you're there.
Oh, then can I take away my precision? Because I used a precision.
That's fine.
Okay.
Why don't you roll the second die first before you
decide
on the precision?
Exactly. Thank you.
Who?
All right. That's a 20 something, 28.
28.
Read the live chat. Did I give anybody vigilant blessing?
I don't remember.
I don't think
Not this morning.
Okay, 28 definitely does hit. Go ahead and roll damage.
Justin, well, I guess I rolled my initiative. We can just keep all those the same. It doesn't really matter. Okay.
This feels fucky.
Yeah.
This feels like we're being fucked.
18, or 8 damage.
You get your sneak attack too, so it is actually the full 24 because you have advantage.
Oh, 24 then.
So the first shot, despite being a damage type that, you know, normally skeletons okay with for the most part. That's still a very sizable shot, and it is actually from a magical weapon, as you're using your moon-touched gloves. Still does significant damage.
Nice.
At that point, they added a back button on initiative. Interesting.
Oh, okay, nice.
Cool. Sorry. At that point, we will roll initiative as the rest of you guys see Rev peek around the corner, kind of swear to himself, and then take a shot down the hallway. Weapons get drawn, and Myetharia, you are the fastest to respond.
I am.
Don't mind the fucky color of this hallway. That's because when we did this live, it was a 2-wide hallway, so I decided that I should make it a 2-wide hallway for this as well.
Color looks fine to me.
No worries. I can't even technically see the hallway yet because I can't see the hallway yet. Yeah.
You will in a second.
Let's see. Where did I want to go?
Before I forget, Justin, as soon as this kicks off, I'm listening for the water to change.
Okay.
This seems like we're getting fucked.
5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. All right. Pretty sure I'm close enough I can shoot at them. Yeah. I will take out my short bow and fire off some shots, I guess, even though it's not going to be great. With, piercing damage.
Yeah, yours is not magical damage.
No, it's not. That's a... Gosh, brain work. 23 to hit.
Does hit? Right?
Yes, 23.
I'm going to assume that you shoot the one with the arrow already sticking out of it.
Yes, I'll go with that. Is that the top one or the bottom one?
The top one. Yeah, the one that Rev already had shot.
That is a 7 piercing.
Okay. 10 to 10.
A little bit of damage.
Second hit. Ah, it rolled off. 18, so 27 to hit.
Sounds good. Does hit.
What's my plus again? My gosh, I keep forgetting. 8 piercing.
Okay.
Only one better than last time. Third attack.
Need.
18 to hit.
18 does hit.
Ooh, that's a little bit better. That's 10 piercing.
Nice.
Bonus action. I rolled a really natural 20, so.
Hey!
I mean, not super pointless, but you know. So
it might actually be enough. Hold on.
4 is 8 plus another 5 is 13 piercing.
Oh, it's not quite enough, unfortunately. The skeleton taking now 5 bolts and arrows collectively is standing on the precipice of re-death. I guess we can call it. But unfortunately, it does still stand upright, and it has turned around, and you start to hear the clanging noises from within have stopped momentarily as they kind of turn all together to look at what's happening.
Oh, how about you come hit a warm target, you idiot? My turn.
Perfect. It is them next, actually. They do get to respond. The one that you shot repeatedly, oops, I opened his token on accident, will kind of come shuffling along out into the hallway a little bit. The next two are going to create like a little bit of a wall. The last one kind of blocking the door. For what it's worth, the top one is the door. The bottom one kind of looks like a door. Trying to redo these things on the fly in 20 minutes before session starts because you just suddenly realized that it was wrong. Really difficult. Beyond that, last one tries to block the door, and then from within, you still are hearing, starting back up, the sounds of bang, 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 as it continues to thump on the water wheel, trying to dislodge it, it seems.
Does it sound, from the sound of the bangs, does it sound like a creature bigger and stronger than these skeletons, or about the same?
Probably not. It sounds like someone who doesn't know what they're doing trying to turn something off by hitting it hard enough.
Oh great. Great.
That's exactly how I try to make things work, too.
Yeah, there you go.
What Rev was planning on doing the water wheel the first time.
Right?
Hit it hard enough.
They do, however, take some defensive postures along the hallway as they try to do so. But Winry, it will be you next and your first opportunity to show off some moves.
Show me your moves.
Show me what you've got.
Funny. So is the first one the one that got hit?
Yes, the first one is the one that got hit lots.
I'll move here.
All right, go for it. From 10 feet away, throwing the living weapon out.
22 to hit?
Definitely hits, and you can roll damage, actually. You know what? I'm not going to take this away from you.
Thanks. So I roll an extra 2d6. Right.
What damage type did you choose?
I'm going to choose cold.
Okay.
Even though it's not the most optimal. And then I also realize that I get to choose the actual attack damage, right? So that will be bludgeoning.
Yep.
Budgeting?
No. Bludgeoning.
Bludgeoning with an L.
So as part of this living weapon subclass, when she makes attacks with her weapon, or her unarmed attacks, she gets to choose if she wants them to be slashing, bludgeoning, or piercing damage. Nice. And then the end of a rest, at the end of a long rest, she chooses a damage type of like 6 of them or something like this. And the first creature that she hits on each of her turns takes an extra amount of damage from that first hit.
Oh, no.
Damage.
That type. Cool. In this case, cold and bludgeoning being very optimal for this particular situation, explodes this first skeleton. It was already on death's door, re-death's door, but after Winry appears, it just
we'll use
blind
agility here.
Okay.
Again.
Top or bottom?
Huh?
Okay. These rolls are at disadvantage now.
Why?
Because they have taken the dodge action.
Oh, right. Okay. Little jerk.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Natural one. And more. Mm-hmm. 18 plus
11. Wow, that was the disadvantage?
Yeah, 18, 19.
Nice. Definitely hits.
13 damage.
The resounding sound, like the thwacking sound from the far end of the hallway as this creature, it's still upright, but it is suffering from that one hit.
Can I add Sling Strike to that one?
Sure you can. It's a con save. 16.
Oh, good. He saves.
Okay.
Next time.
Anything else, Winry?
Yep, I have. That was 10 feet of movement to get there. 20 feet of movement.
Yeah, so you still have like 30 more feet to move if you want to or something like that. Yes, I know. You can move basically the entire length of the castle in a turn. Where do you want to be on this map?
That's
really saying something.
Okay. Bryn.
Just clarifying, these are the fiery eye boys.
Yes.
The boys.
Hey boys.
Oh,
hey, boys. 5, 10, 15, 20.
Yep. As soon as they saw Rev at the end of the hallway, their eyes lit up.
20. Okay, I'm gonna shoot a sacred flame down. There's no way I knew which one Winry hit, so I'm just gonna shoot at the one. No, I'll shoot there and then I'll move down.
Okay, so top or bottom?
Top. Well, I can I see? Yeah, I can shoot through it.
Yep, you're fine with a save thing, yep.
All right, it's a save, yes. Bottom.
Dex save 15.
He fails. Because my saves are now 18.
What? Nice.
No.
Oh, that is 11 plus 4 is 15 damage.
15 radiant?
Radiant damage.
Perfect. It is barely holding together after that. It bones are rattled.
That's all I got.
Rev, see you next.
Gonna move there, move right in front of I can move through Winry's square. Maybe even just like slide around her. Fire my crossbow again. Let's see, so that is 16 to hit.
Yes, okay, I understand. 16 does hit actually for this guy.
Nice.
They do not actually have shields. They carry a sword in one hand, and that's it.
10 damage.
10 is enough for the top skeleton to fall to pieces. Two down.
Great. And I'm going to... Nice. Let me see. Move right here. I think I have 10 more feet of movement, so I'm going to move forward and use my bonus action to quick draw my rapier and stow
Very nice.
My crossbow. So I'm ready with
changing
that.
Over.
Yep. Let's go. Let's go. Let's
Perfect. Go. Jack, last one to come around the corner.
I actually, I'll tell you what I would like to do, Justin, and then you can give a yay or nay, and then I'll narrate.
Okay.
I want to use my whole turn to run back to the lift and place the immovable rod in a corner.
Oh, okay. Sure, I'm good with that.
Okay.
I would say, though, it's probably going to take your turn just to get there and place it, we'll say.
Yeah, that's fine. I'm saying okay. I want to use my whole turn to get there and place it, if you'll allow it.
Yep, I'm good with that.
Okay.
Jack goes... So, yeah, sorry, I won't narrate. You said you were going to narrate it.
I see that it's you guys are handling a skeleton seemingly fine. I'm going to start booking it back to the lift, and I'm taking out of my bag of holding, like, my bedroll, my blanket, fine clothes, disguise kit, just any, like, bundle of random shit that doesn't look valuable, but that's a big pile of stuff. And I'm going to run into the lift in the corner and say, there's a fight. I got to leave this here. And I'm going to set it down in the corner. And when I set it down, I'm going to set the rod underneath it and activate it.
Okay.
And then be like, okay, well, I'll be back. And then run back out.
Sounds good. For the time being, you've just run there and set it.
That's
you
fine.
Get a bunch of confused looks on the other side as they're still eating their breakfast sausages. But a couple of them... jump up in kind of defense, so to speak. The biggest one being Grelfin, the paladin, jumps to his feet, kind of foregoing the rest of his breakfast, and starts moving towards the entrance to try to, like, block off the doorway, so to speak, to make sure that nothing can get in at the rest of his party.
So he stops me, or like he's surprised nope. enough that I get through first? Okay.
Oh, no, he's not trying to stop you. He's okay, trying to stop anything else from coming in after you.
Oh, he thought like maybe I was running away from something.
Yeah. So he came out like sticking his head out and is like, nothing else is coming in here.
Perfect. And that's it.
Okay. The next thing that happens. Yeah, not Mytharia's turn yet, turns out. Bryn and Myetharia, though, you guys watch as coming through the wall is
what
a
the
creature.
Oh!
What did this happen last time?
A spectral creature phasing through the wall as it steps towards you. And as it does so, it says,
Griot will not let you up.
And he reaches one hand out towards you, Bryn, and you can feel the coldness try to seep over you. Rolls a 21 to hit.
Yeah.
I thought, I was so certain it was the Boulette back for revenge.
Yeah, me too. Yeah, because you said goes through wool.
No. Can you please roll a constitution saving throw for me?
Come on.
Constitution did not change.
This guy looks bad.
Ooh, 19.
Okay. You take 30 points of necrotic damage. And you feel for a moment like your life was being siphoned from you. But you resist any residual effects from the damage. As he kind of floats in your space, like surrounding the two of you. Kind of, yeah, just angrily, eyes flaring, looking towards you.
Oh, this is not good.
Bam.
He then turns back a little bit and says,
come now.
And the floor begins to rumble.
No.
Oh.
And bursting up through the floor between the two of you is our great friend, Landshark Bullet, popping through the floor.
We spoke too soon.
You did. You spoke too soon. It had a lower initiative, actually.
We counted our chickens.
As it burst
I'm
going to
say I yelled so that Jack could hear me yell.
Bullet!
No, just a scream of terror as this thing popped out the wall.
It does it.
Can I get a legendary action to reaction punch it? Because I was so scared.
Legendary reaction.
You're flailing.
Interesting.
Just this one time.
Interesting. I'll consider it.
Because it scared me.
Pops up between Winry and Rev, and as it does so, it is going to try to take a chomping bite out from Rev's backside.
This went tits up real fast.
It rolls a natural 2. And so, fortunately,
that was a little slow there.
And I'm going to that I'm going to riposte.
Riposte.
Ooh, you get sneak attack.
And I get to use sneak attack, so I'm gonna hit him with the rapier. Let's see.
Nice.
Oh, I should have killed the bullet.
And I think I also, let me see. Let me just check the way, because this is my first time using this. When it misses me with a melee, use a reaction, spend one superiority die, make a melee, add the superiority die to the attack's damage roll. Okay, so damage, 19 to hit.
19 does hit.
Oh, oof, that was a close one. So,
fucking bullet.
Does the bullet look like it's injured? Like it had to.
And max damage on the 8. So 34?
34 points of damage.
34 very nice. Points of damage.
Sir, comes up in...
No.
Yeah,
what
so.
What sneak attack does.
Yeah, so it nips at me, but I managed to kind of like place my foot on its nose and chin. So it kind of like riding it, I'm riding it like up, and as it does, I'm like plunging it down into its face.
Very nice. Very nice that you also said last turn you changed over to the rapier.
Wasn't that a cool
crossbow out?
Pretty dope. Very, yeah, pretty dope move, honestly. I'm really excited about that one.
The bullet has kind of crushed its way up through the floor tiles, but it is ineffectual and is in fact punished. Myetharia, it will be your turn next.
Is it a free action to drop bow and take out swords, or would you prefer that?
If you drop it on the ground, yes, it is a free action to drop, and then it would be a minor to draw.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, drop
you have to, and draw. If you're drawing two, I should say. A the minor. First draw is free. The second draw is minor.
Okay, so my bonus action then.
Bonus, bud.
Yeah.
Or Sorry, 4E rears its ugly head.
I was going to say, that's a weird term to use. I think I know what he means, but...
Justin and I were talking 4E earlier.
No worries. Okay, oh goodness. All right, then won't be able to light the swords, but I will start wailing on this guy who's popped up next to us. I do not like him.
I do not like them.
All right, first attack. That is a 21 to hit.
That does hit.
Oh, not great. Remind me my... that's a... Sorry, math. 8 slashing on him for the first one.
Okay. Second the sword attack. Slashes through. It does seem to be effective, at least.
Good. That's good. Okay. Well, they are magic, so... second one's a natural one. And the third one...
I only mention it because he's like a spectral and like partially incorporeal.
Yeah, like a race. Yeah. Okay, well, the third one is a 29, so.
Nice,
you know.
Definitely hits.
Just takes on a roller coaster.
I know, you know, that's just what my dice do. And that is a 11 slashing damage.
Very nice. Two strikes cut through.
That's all I can do. Actually, how's he looking?
Those were the first two hits.
Yeah.
Oh, I guess we rested.
We did rest, yeah. Alright, I'm gonna use my action surge.
Okay.
Yeah.
For this guy. So I believe I get 3 more attacks on him.
Yep, you get a full another action.
Okay. Not great. 16.
16 does hit.
Whoa, that's intimidating. Okay. That's a plus 6. 20. Sorry. Brain, work, please. 7 plus 6 is
13.
13. Thank you. 13 slashing damage.
No problem.
Second one. A 28 to hit.
Wow, very nice.
This die more. This die's been saving. That is another 13 slashing.
Very nice. It's starting to actually look like the sword strikes are having an effect.
Good. All right, third and last. Yep. This is really a roller coaster. 12, because I rolled a 2.
12 does not hit, unfortunately.
All right.
Still, though, 4 of 6 slashes do land and do a substantial amount of damage.
Good work. That's what we want to see. Myetharia, the whirling dervish.
The stone cold killer.
That's my turn.
Very nice. On their turn, the skeletons will begin to charge, and they will charge towards Rev. Moving in, they make a couple of attacks each. First guy makes 2 attacks. It is a 15 and a 22 to hit.
Both hit. Wait, 15?
15.
Yeah, that hits.
The first one then, assuming you don't have any resistance to fire or necrotic, is that correct?
No.
Okay, first one will be 9 points of damage then. And the second one is 11 points of damage, so 20 total.
Okay.
The second guy attacks twice. One definitely hits, the other one is a 13, which misses.
Okay, yeah, the one hits. Just to check, riposte is 1 reaction, so I guess I can't use any kind
Correct.
Of...
Yeah, right. You only have 1 reaction until it's your turn again.
And I can't use Uncanny Dodge. That's fine.
And you can't use that. Yep. The one that does hit with the second guy deals 12 points of damage in total.
Okay.
Annoying when you remember to use it and you've already used your reaction.
The last one The last thing that happens, you continue to hear noises from ahead as one skeleton, it seems like, continues to try to crack
defiantly
the water wheel apart in the distance. Winry, you're up next. Kind of boxed in.
I'm going to use a Step of the Wind.
Okay.
In one key point to disengage from the bullet. Actually, I don't have to.
Nope. You don't have to.
Okay.
You can hit whoever you want here.
I won't do that. I'll have that back. And I'm going to attack the other guy that Myetharia has been attacking.
Okay. Go for it.
Twenty-seven
definitely hits.
Plus 2d6 of cold damage.
So tell me the cold damage separate.
Eight points of bludgeoning, eight points of cold. Yeah.
15 dang, girl. And 8. Okay. Okay, perfect.
And again.
Yes.
Now two. Oh, not a two. 19 hit.
That's hit.
11 damage.
Okay. It is barely holding together after the flurry of blows that came from all of you.
Kill
it! It's still there.
My flurry of blows.
You have more targets.
A flurry of blows. That 22 to hit.
Definitely hits. 3
to hit.
Definitely hits.
11 damage.
The creature, after a full frontal assault, is ripped to pieces. This specter, and as it does so, it kind of fades away and dissipates into the ether. It says, as it dies, says,
"You fools! The pyre will burn you all."
As the voice fades away.
Do I assume that he was talking in the third person when he said Griot won't let you go up?
That's an up to you.
Yeah, up to you.
I'm gonna use my last attack at the bullet.
Go for it.
Based on what is inflection?
Was he referring to someone else? That's what
18
I thought
does hit.
I think he was talking to us.
13 damage.
Very nice. Anything else on your turn, Henry?
I want to eat him.
Feeling hurt.
You'll get over it. 2 A's. It's 2 A's.
Oh, wait, I can move that away at least because that's within my reach, right?
G-R-A-A-A-A. No, works the other way around.
Yeah, does it work the other way around?
So it depends on. It depends on the other person's reach, yeah. So right. You'd be moving out of the bullet's reach.
Okay.
Okay. Bryn, it's you.
All right, I'm gonna cast Moonbeam on the bullet.
Ooh.
Second level.
Moonbeam.
Moonshadow.
Moonshadow. Moonshadow.
Con 18, 5-foot radius. Oh wait, when a creature enters a spell area for the first time on a turn or starts its turn there. So does it do it now?
Can we look it up?
Write it to me.
Oh, you're right. I should have. Sorry.
Should have what?
Those to you. Yeah, I noticed that it was blinking red for you, Cassie. I was wondering if it was dying.
It's still at 10%. It won't shut up.
No.
What's
the question?
The way that it's phrased, I would say that it will take the damage on its turn.
Okay.
You ruled on this in the last campaign, but I don't remember what it was.
Did I?
Yeah, because Orym had it.
Enters the spell's area for the first time.
I actually had to do some research on it.
Yeah.
I had to do some research on it for my game. I ruled it as it happens on its turn, okay. Not on your turn. Because if it happened on your turn, then in theory you just have a beam of death that you can just weave around the battlefield and everyone would take damage.
Yeah. Well, it takes an action to move it, though.
Yeah, but if the idea is if you are causing them to enter for the first time, then you could choose the pattern and do the damage to everybody, and that's too strong for a second level spell.
Gotcha.
On the second turn, though, she can do that, I would say.
She can move it, but it still won't cause the damage until the creature's turn. It makes it so you can only hit one person a turn as opposed to a bunch of people. That's how I ruled it. But if you want to rule it different, that's up to you.
I'll look into it. I'm curious.
Yeah, I'm okay with it.
I would say, though, ultimately, it does not do damage immediately on first turn. I'll say that for sure.
Okay.
So, yeah, Moonbeam is up over the bullet.
Oh, okay.
I'm going to have it right, like, on this side of the bullet.
The one real downside to Moonbeam, of course, being it is not party friendly.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
It is when a creature enters.
Oh, okay.
But it's only 5 feet, isn't it?
Yeah, it's only 5 feet. Yeah,
5 foot radius.
So it's 10?
So it'd be a 10 foot diameter.
Oh, what?
So these spells... you pick a corner for them to start at, and it does 5 feet in every direction.
Pick your
corner, where you want it to start. You can have it start on the wall if you want, and only fill half the corridor. That's fine, but
maybe if she picks this part, that's just the bullet.
You can also pick the very center of the bullet, and it is just literally the bullet circle is the moonbeam currently. That's also fine. I just wanted to know where you were setting it.
When I move it, can I move it so it's like half in the wall and half?
As long as you can see the point that you're moving it through, yes.
So like if I move it there, then...
Yeah, you can't move it fully into the wall, but you can move it to the wall's edge, yes.
All right, I think I want to try this. We're going to try it. I haven't used it, ironically.
Let's do it.
Okay, so it's dropping directly on the bullet, or what's the...
I'm gonna put it right here in hopes that one of the dumb skeletons moves into it.
Like that?
Yeah.
Perfect. Cassie is furiously trying to figure out headphone situation. Okay.
That's all.
Very nice.
Oh, y'all jazz?
It is prepped, and you hear footsteps from behind, presumably. But we'll get to Jack in a moment. Rev, it's you first.
Well, let me get this straight. This moonbeam triggers at the end of the bullet's turn.
It will trigger at the start of any creature's turn that either goes into or starts their turn in it.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So if you move into the moonbeam on your turn, then it would cause damage to you.
Oh, man.
No.
All right. I'm going to do what I was going to do, and I'm just going to attack the bullet.
Go for it.
Skeleton.
Seems like a good move.
26 to hit. 26
hits.
To hit.
Nice.
And that is 32 damage.
Damn.
Nice. Very nice.
It is suffering big time. It is still kind of gnashing its teeth, so to speak, but it is bleeding heavily out of two massive wounds that you've given it.
Yeah.
Yeah, probably true. Do you have buds?
Bonus action, disengage. The bullet is bigger than me, right? Like, it's two sizes bigger than me?
It is one size bigger than me.
No, it's two sizes. Isn't he small?
Oh, you're right, right, right. For Rev, you're correct.
Which means I can move through its square.
Yes.
All right. So I'm going to slip through.
Ooh, smart.
Underneath this guy. Very bonus smart. Action, disengage. And, yeah. Hit right here.
Don't you get a free disengage from mobile?
No, I have to attack. So these guys here would have been able to attack me. So
that's who you attack. I got you.
Yeah. So he's not able to attack me. The bullet isn't, but the...
I gotcha.
Yeah. All right, and that is my turn.
Where are you right now?
Right here.
He's in the hallway.
Oh, you went... Oh, gee.
Yeah,
I looked away to find headphones for Cassie. I didn't realize how far away you'd gone.
Oh, yeah, I fled. I peased out.
He fled the scene.
He did his job. Fled the
Jack,
scene.
It's you next.
Okay, before I leave, I'm going to summon Puck, and I'm going to put him on the pile of stuff, and I'll say, don't let anyone touch it. And I'll look to the rest of them and say, he looks small, but he is a death raptor. Don't touch him, and don't make him angry. In fact, don't make eye contact with him. He's very dangerous. And then I'll just book it back. So I'm just going to spend all my turn to get back to everybody else. There we go. All right, it's my turn.
I don't know. You might get a little bit of reverb. We'll see.
You always do.
Cassie's Bluetooth headphones
are dead.
Are dead.
They and aren't so. Dead, though. There's 10% left, but they just think.
Oh,
I'm
sorry.
I'm dying.
I do that 20%.
Hopefully, we don't hear any looping reverb because she has.
It
her
actually
phone
sounds
just...
better.
That's okay.
Anyway, sorry. So, Jack, you come charging back, see a scene that looks actually reasonably in control so far.
Yeah.
Yeah, because you didn't see the scary guy come out of the frickin'
That's
wall.
True. I just saw him and I'm like, oh, it's the bullet again. You rascal.
You heard Bryn scream and came running, expecting the worst. Come over here and find. It's actually not that bad.
It's a mostly dead bullet. I look at him really quick. Does he have the immovable rod stuck in him anywhere? Son of a bitch.
It might still be back there.
Oh, don't. I'm going to use my next turn to run back there and see if I can find it. You guys got this covered.
Well, it is the bullet's turn next, and...
Oh, no. Does he see me?
Oh, at start of his, hold on. At start of his turn, it takes damage, yeah. Right? Or makes a save?
First and foremost.
Con save 18.
Con save. Okay.
Shut.
Natural one.
Oh. All right. Hey, double damage for crit fail.
Ooh, 13 radiant damage.
Nice.
Okay, it is still alive.
He's coming after me, isn't he?
Boy, it sees such a good opportunity.
It also sees me, so I mean, it also sees me, who he had a grudge against last time.
Please
the
come
Jack comes
me.
Around the corner.
Please make
it
me
makes,
quit.
It makes eye contact. And when it does, you see these sad eyes full of hurt and betrayal as it remembers what happened. And it will take a leap, a long jump leap, as it comes flying out from the ground.
It's totally jawsing me!
Sailing past Winry. Winry, you have a 10-foot reach, right? So you do actually get a chance to hit it. Yeah, you do. You have a chance to hit it before it lands here.
This is my favorite.
No. This is what you come around the corner to like,
hit.
Oh, hey!
20 to hit?
Oh, crap.
That does hit.
I'm trying to remember the last thing that Quint said.
Well...
And lands lifelessly on the stones, sliding up to Jack as it does so. Its sad eyes slowly fade from the fire and just looks up at you, Jack, like, why? Why did you let this happen to me? As it dies.
Oh my gosh.
Between the moonbeam and the punch there, actually, might have saved yourself a lot of damage as well.
Oh my gosh.
A wonderful moment.
And a really wonderful moment.
Oh, that was a campaign highlight right there. Oh, I'm crying.
Jack's wow. Boo. Jack's boo came through too. It was Jack's.
That's true. Winry saved me.
He saved his life.
Well, Myetharia, you watched this land shark free Willy over top of Winry. But unfortunately, unlike Free Willy, didn't touch him on the belly. Instead, socks him.
No, that's what she's doing.
Belly.
She's reaching up to do the move and punches him in the stomach.
Yep. And it flops on the other side like a dead fish out of water. It's your turn, Myetharia.
Yeah.
Gosh, I wanted him to jaws me so bad.
That's something to recover from. Yeah, because her last encounter, she nearly got taken down by this thing. So after a moment, the skeletons are all that are left. I have 10, 15, 20, 25. Yeah, I think I can get around this beam in the hallway without touching it. And I'll just hit this guy.
Wow. Ooh, dang.
That's 19 to hit.
19 Ooh. Does hit.
What the fuck? Where are you getting this boulette from?
It's a special boulette.
Oh, okay.
It's been touched it's by the pyre.
It's special.
Here.
What?
Yeah, not
that's
anymore.
10 slashing on this guy.
Okay.
That's only a 16 to hit.
16 does hit.
Okay. Ooh, that's a 13 slashing on that one.
How much? Sorry.
13 damage.
13? Very nice.
You're good.
First one's starting to struggle.
Oh my gosh. Okay.
18 to hit.
18 does hit.
Fucking great. I also just realized that I pretty much like rounded the corner, made eye contact with it, and it dove at me to try to get me.
100%.
Hey guys, what's going on?
Very nice. And one more.
One more. A 21 to hit.
Does hit.
Is another 10 slashing.
It is still upright, just barely.
Alright, cool. That's my turn.
It needed another couple of damage, unfortunately.
That's just fine.
It is now their turn.
That's what I wanted.
On their turn, they will take a full round of attacks towards you, Myetharia, with their short swords. First one. Oh, wow. 21 and 24 to hit.
Gosh, that's a little unnecessary. Oh yes, they both hit.
Too many freaking alarms.
First one deals. You have no fire or necrotic resistance, right?
Nope.
I already took it. Like 10 minutes ago.
The first one deals a total of, for the first slash, 23 points of damage as Rev, you got off light because I forgot that these guys get sneak attack from each other.
Aww. Oh, no. Isn't that cute?
Congratulations
so cute.
On getting
We're
off
buddies.
Light. The second slash from that same guy deals 12 total points of damage. The second guy then attacks, since he is still upright, was able to give that advantage. Unfortunately, only rolls a 14 as the higher roll, so neither of his strikes will find target, but he did give his friend a little bit of bonus damage, at least.
Do you want to humor me and tell me what the sneak attack is?
Nope.
Oh, okay.
Sure don't.
Forgot it in the time. It's been a full round. My fault.
I'm just curious. I think I could have taken it.
Oh, I'm sure you could. It was only 3d6. So all right. It wouldn't have been that big of a deal. Winry, you're up next.
Why do I have a sliver around me?
I don't see it.
You don't.
Oh, because you're selecting yourself?
Okay, never mind. Can I...
Can you hit around her?
Yeah.
You could hit the bottom guy.
I know that
the top one would be difficult.
Purple circle
is a moonbeam that seemed to scald the bullet, at least. Okay. You could hit the bottom guy for sure. The top one would have some cover because
we'll
of Myetharia.
Start with the bottom one.
Dean does not hit, actually. It kind of flangs off his breastplate.
26.
That does hit.
8 bludgeoning.
And?
11 cold.
Okay, so 8, 11, 19, 38 points of damage from that first strike.
Oh!
As it is weak to both bludgeoning and cold.
Holy shit!
14 does not hit.
Sit.
Not gonna flurry him.
Fine. 22.
Does hit.
That's DM pressure. That's.
Yeah.
That bad?
That's a leave the party offense right there.
Smash. The next one goes flying.
Take down the next one.
No, one still remains resolutely in the way.
I'm gonna get out of the way.
And then there's the guy.
There's one still banging on the stuff.
There is one in the back still, yep. No one's been able to get to him yet.
Nope.
Bryn.
Okay. I'm calculating. I'm not walking into my moonbeam. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6. Just so I can see. Because I can't see this guy in here at all, right?
Nope, doesn't seem like it.
But I was in that room, so could I guess and move my moonbeam in there?
It's a small room. You might get a chance
What's
to hit it.
What's the range on movement?
60.
Yeah, just drop it in there.
You do have to be able to see it, though, is the hard part. Like the center of the moonbeam.
It's 10.
I would say
I'm
at
gonna
least.
Drop it. So I wouldn't be that far. I guess I'll move it. I'll move up behind Myetharia and well, I don't need to be that far. I just need to see it. Hold on. Yeah, I'll just drop it where I can see it. I think here. Where the center is here. It goes down farther.
Like that?
Oh, I thought... Okay.
So
Arius goes... Oh, no. So he said that's not a door. This is a door.
Oh, so this is where I can see through?
No, you can see through the top one, not the bottom
okay.
one.
Yeah.
Yeah, sorry. It's
no, that's little, what I was thinking. I just didn't... I thought the circle would go down from there. But
he said you gotta see the center.
Okay, gotcha. Okay. I'll leave it there.
Okay.
No, gosh, I don't want to do that if that room is small.
Why?
Because then we can't go in and get him. Damn it.
You can just...
Put, yeah, that, do that.
Do that.
That's what I'm going to do. Do that. Okay, thanks, bye. I'm done.
Oh, okay. It's your action?
My action to do that.
Oh.
Yeah, that's why Moonbeam is not that overpowered.
Yeah.
I would say, for just right now, until I know better, I would say it has entered the moonbeam at this point in time, though. On a turn. I would say it has entered the spell area for the first time on a turn. I don't know. It's so
funny. We didn't do it that way for clarifying that. And well. He's not going to move, so just.
Sure, that's fine.
Crawford is ruled, or I actually think Chris.
Perkins
responded. His stuff tends to have a little more legitimacy. Crawford just says whatever the fuck he thinks at that moment.
Okay. Rev.
You know what I'm gonna do, baby. 19 to hit.
19 hits.
Taking his time. 24 damage.
Well, the skeleton highlighted by the moonbeam, very spotlighted, unfortunately, does blow up with the attack. I do agree, actually, Rob. I think that it has to move to enter the beam, not the beam moving to enter. So, yeah, I think it's just really crappily written.
Yes,
you know, 5e spells.
Because, like, if there was a line of those guys, if it was when the beam did it, she could just move straight through, and they would all take that damage, which is not—that's too much for a second level spell.
You know, I've never done it before, and I wanted to.
It's a cool spell.
I probably won't use it too much, but it's always prepared, so it doesn't matter.
It's free for you.
Yeah.
Rev, anything else on your turn?
Bonus action. I'm gonna sneak up here and can I peek around the corner? I want to stay right here, but I'd like to peek around the corner to see who's in here.
There is a skeleton.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm gonna stay. Oops. I'm gonna stay right here. Well, because that's as far as I can move anyway. With
I was just dragging you so you can see
dash.
It.
All right, done.
Jack, you're next. The sad corpse of your used-to-be friend at your feet.
I just sacrificed my whole turn to stare at him and feel guilty.
Speaking of, there's Finn. Ramming himself in.
I mean, I still can't see the skeleton, so I don't know. I'll use my full turn to get up there. When I go past, I'll look a little shaken, but I'll say, like, thanks, Winry, that was really close.
Tears kind of forming at the corners of his eyes.
Yeah. I'm glad you killed him.
Perfect. Myetharia, you next.
Yeah.
I choke down the tears because I don't want to see the sliver of the Stormrider Falcon or the Stormrider Eagle seeing me cry.
What? See you weak.
Yeah. I bite my lip.
I will also move up. Can I? Let me see. Can I see anything? Just 30 feet. My gosh, roll 20 slow. I kind of see something. That's unhelpful. So very unhelpful. All right, now I'll just use the rest of my turn to move in next to the guy. He's like, hey, what you doing?
He's like paused mid-swing with his short sword.
Please don't. That's very unhelpful.
What just happened, Cassie?
And he knocked Cassie's phone perch.
Pretty Dougie. I think that's all I can do.
Okay. It is the creature's turn. And we're going to have it give one more whack to the water wheel.
Persistent.
Let's see what happens.
Persistent,
yes. And at least it give him
swings,
that.
Lands a solid blow. And it starts leaking.
Oh no.
A spray of water through the air.
Henry! Help!
I'm heading.
But didn't you just get rid of your mending spell?
Oh, yep. Yes, we don't have mending anymore.
Oh, fuck.
Well, yes! She calls for you, Winry. It's your turn.
Yes, I will go to...
Winry, do you want me to measure for you?
30. 40. And then I have to let you know.
I didn't need to measure it if you had feline agility. Goodness.
Goodness.
I'm flying in. Punches a flying.
Funny.
I didn't want to forget.
That does hit.
No.
Well, bludgeon. Three cold.
Being 30 points of damage from the first strike.
Oh. 24.
That's hit.
Zero on a 10.
That's a 10.
10. So 17.
Oof. Just decimates this poor last skeleton. However, damage has been done, and the pipe is leaking the pressure that you had just spent so long trying to build.
Are we at
anything else on your turn, Winry?
I have a bunch of scars, colorful scars. The hole.
I don't think they're going to hold against very, very high pressure water.
Oh no!
Maybe an immovable rod would work.
If I go in there, can I? Are we out of initiative?
Are we out of initiative?
What do you got, Bryn?
I control water.
Oh.
But at least help.
Okay.
So,
I have nothing.
Just until... Okay, hold up a minute. My action. Okay, so concentration up to 10 minutes. Mm-hmm. I can redirect the flow, causing it to move in a direction that I choose so that it bypasses the hole. Once it gets past the area of effect, it goes back, but I could just keep the pressure there while they fix it.
Yep, that's great. I love that a lot.
Yeah, that's really good.
So,
you guys got 10 minutes.
I'm going to find a riveting machine and some spare scrap metal here. Do we have that? Any of those things?
You had some odds and ends equipment and tools. You found a pipe fitting last time.
Oh yeah, like if I could find a big clamp, I could probably find like a wrench and some screws and clamp that baby down.
Give it a go.
Okay.
You gonna make a dexterity check for me?
Straight roll?
Since you're not proficient in tinker's tools, so I think it would just be a dexterity check.
I'll
Oh wait, wrong roll, but I rolled a 5.
Wait, I'll drop in enhance ability. Give you a, because this would be a dex check, right?
This would be a dexterity check, yes.
Yep. I'll give you enhance ability. I'll tap you in. You'll feel that oh so familiar spryness. Give you advantage on dex checks.
Feels good.
I'll say, you can do it, Rev. We believe in you. And I'll give you a Bardic Inspiration also.
16, and Bardic Inspiration is a D...
8. Nope. It's a D10 now.
Ooh, snap.
I was going to ask you when it went up.
Whoa.
It just did.
I'll give you the 2. it got worse as he moved from an 8 to a 10.
Yeah, I mean 17 or 18, one of the two.
Well, I was going to have you have to beat the strength score of the skeleton that created the problem. And as such, it rolled a total of a 16 for its strength check.
Wow. Close one.
Turns out that bardic inspiration was the...
That was what changed it.
Yeah.
So without the disadvantage of having to fight through the massive amount of water pressure that was being lost and spraying in your face, you're able to just enough seal this back up, putting on a temporary patch to the best of your ability, kind of using like some wrenches and this sort of thing to kind of clamps to secure something in place that you think will hold. And as Bryn kind of lessens her grip on the water for a moment, the pressure remains. The damage was not permanent. And you can hear once more the system filling and the pressure building.
Good work, team. High fives all around.
Bryn, that was really smart.
So how long does it take Reb to fix it? About?
5 minutes.
Okay, so I'd say while we're still sitting here for the, because control water is another 5 minutes, I'm going to still push the water in that direction so it builds the pressure back faster.
Nice. Oh, good. Yeah. Yeah.
Give you a little extra push. Power.
Oomph.
Winry, can you go with me back to the hallway room to see if the immovable rod is still there?
All the way back there?
Not all the way. Isn't it one room over?
Isn't it like on a different level?
No, it's right there. We just go down this hallway and loop over there. I just want Winry to come with me in case something's there.
To make out?
Sure. Finding a movable rod, you know what I'm saying?
Gross.
I feel like you want
just leave it, Justin.
All right, fair point.
Oh my gosh.
Anyway,
so heading back over there, passing the door to the elevator, the halflings will be standing at kind of relative alert with Grelfin in front, defending the doorway.
Oh wait, I'll go up to the doorway then, and I'll be like, "We're good. Situation handled. The water pressure's building." And I'll kind of like sneak past him, and then I'll look at Puck, and I'll say, "Nine." And he like, I command him to like look like he's relaxed, like that's the command word for him to not attack. And then he kind of relaxes, and I'm like, "All right, good. You did your job. Now go pick him up, put him on my shoulder, and pick up all my stuff, including the other immovable rod." And then be like, okay, we'll be right back.
Make a perception check for me, would you?
Okay. Terrible. 15.
Okay. Looking over your stuff as you go over to it, you're not sure if anything has moved or not. You do know Puck is not particularly dangerous looking, being a tiny little owl. And you do see a few eyes kind of looking in that direction when you came around the corner. But it doesn't look like anything was moved, you don't think, as you collect it all back together. Giving it a once-over in your pack, the movable rod is still there. Giving it once over to your pack, you don't notice anything that's gone.
All right. Then I'll shove it back into my bag. So I'll open up my cloak and start shoving it into my bag of holding. And then we can head up to the hallway to see.
Okay. Up in the hallway, you find where the bullet was. The movable rod is not there.
Hmm. Oh, boy.
That's disappointing.
Where is it?
I don't know. Where is it?
Someone had to turn it off. Someone had to deactivate it to let the boulette free, so it had help. Might have been I assume you guys tell me about the ghost that came out of the wall and attacked you. Might have been the that apparition somehow. Oh well, maybe we'll find it later.
Before you got in the room, I all.
Oh. He wasn't there when I got there. Was that what Bryn screamed at, or was it the... I thought it was the blood. No.
No, there was another guy. But it...
He said something about...
Sure you did. Okay. Yeah. He was big and had really long like teeth and really scary. Anyway.
Didn't he say something about the Inquisitor?
Yeah,
so we can have this conversation. Winry and I'll head back to.
So now I understand why you guys are laughing at me, because Griot's the name of the Inquisitor, and I just didn't know what the name of the Inquisitor was. So
No, that's not why I was laughing. You were like, "Does he mean that the first person or the third person?" And it's like, how are you going to get that from inflection? Like, that's not something you just pick up.
Yeah, it is.
No, it's not. Anyway, we head back. So I still don't think we should bring Clan Maloran with us. Hey, that's just loud enough for us to hear. But we kind of have to have a consensus now, because I think it might turn into a fight.
Yeah, it's definitely after what happened this morning. We didn't tell them that we were just going to go up.
The other thing, too...
Did Myetharia say she didn't want us to do that?
I had suggested that we should say something to them first.
Hmm.
Inferred like, is a better way to say it.
Oh. your inference gives you license to be sultry.
I don't need license to be sultry. She doesn't need license to be sultry. To be sassy. None of those.
So to avoid a potential fight, another thing that we can do is, since we were able to rest, I prepared locate objects so we can say you can come up, but we get to choose which way we can go so we can get a head start towards the porch.
But they won't, they don't have any reason to agree. Like, they could totally say yes, and then once we get up there, they just split.
But then we follow them.
But we're the only ones who know the passcode to the lift.
But they're on the lift.
They're on the lift, yeah.
No, they'll just say that we can get on the lift if we give them the pass, or if we all go out together. Do we have any leverage on them at all? Well, we can just go talk to them and maybe see if they'll understand our position. But if it does come down to a fight, I mean, how does everyone feel about that?
I think that's our only leverage. Fighting.
I don't think that they can't. I think they just choose not to.
I think we would still win, but it would potentially drain our resources, and also we might accidentally kill a few of them.
If that is a risk we're going to take, I think we should heal up first.
Oh yeah, I forgot I got hit for a third of my hit points.
We should take a short rest. Oh yeah, because we can do that in 15 minutes, right?
Either way, you have a little bit of time. The pressure still needs to finish building.
Oh, that's true. Yeah, so let's take a short rest.
I think I only have a couple more hit dice left, and I know some people have none.
Well, we got some back from our long rest.
Oh yeah, we did. Oh, that's nice. I have nine now.
I'm going to see that Bryn is hurt, and I'm going to go over to Rev, and I'm just going to whisper to him, "Hey, turns out if you run away the whole fight, you don't get hurt."
That's fair.
Yeah, and?
It's just, I never realized that before. It seems so elementary, but still an interesting discovery.
Yeah, are you planning on running way more?
Well, no.
All right, well, yeah, because that's kind of my thing.
That's true, that is my thing.
One thing per person.
Yeah, that's my thing. You can't do that.
Well, I guess...
If that's true, though, then Winry's thing is stealth.
Usually run all the way away, typically, though. But, yeah. I guess that's not what I do.
Oh, there go a bunch of your poor hit dice again, huh?
I'm good now, so...
Oh, you were good before. You had 69 health.
Oh, nice.
Nice.
Well, what do we think, guys? Should we fight? Should we let them come up? Where do we stand?
Better we talk to them first.
Well, we're not going to be able to go in and get a temperature on the situation, then be like, okay, we'll be right back. We have to go in there ready.
I don't think that we should fight them.
Yeah, but I also agree. I don't get up.
So I'll just...
Process.
Man, excuse me. I'll just make my case really quick. They have not done much to help us other than give us a few nods and a little bit of information. And it's possible that they've been hiding their full capabilities until we got them up to this room. And then we have no idea what's going to happen when they get up there. And the ramifications could potentially be we lose the torch. And we don't know who they're working for. We don't honestly even know why they're here, other than to get treasure. But, I mean, that's a hokey-ass reason, if you ask me. That's Jack saying that. They had to get through miles of fire to get here and rob some treasure. I don't buy it, and I think they're here for another reason. And the only other reason that I can see they'd be here is the torch.
Definitely agree with you on that. I just don't know if it's worth a fight right now. Because if we are wrong, we're losing allies.
But if we're right, then once they get up there, they are slippery, and they could very easily outmaneuver us and get the torch before we do.
I mean, like I said, I do have the benefit today.
What you're talking about is a huge, huge risk, essentially. So... If you are willing to take a huge risk, hey, that's fine. I'm on the fence about it. I don't really know what they're about. I'm not even going to try to guess what they're about. But,
I think we're taking a huge risk by letting them up there.
Well,
Justin, I guess another thing, too, just the mechanics of locate object. Would the torch be something that was in Legends that would have had pictures and I would have known what it looked like? Or
yeah, reasonably.
Okay. Just don't want to say, hey, I got a locate object, and you're like, nah, well, it don't work.
I say if we talk to them... Bryn.
You go, Becca. You started.
We should definitely go with Bryn's plan. I think that's smart. But I would say if we talk to them first, and you do get a solid read on them that they are being deceptive, and... Then yes, I would vote for fight. Only if you get a solid read that, only if we are positive they are being deceptive.
Well, there's no certainty, obviously, and that one that does all the talking is a pretty squirrely one.
It's a smooth talker, that.
Well, it sounds like the consensus is don't fight. So... We'll go with Bryn's plan, it sounds like.
Yeah.
Which again was use locate object and we lead the way.
Mm-hmm. We get to choose which way we go.
And they have to help in a fight. How about that? They don't get to go sneak around the castle anymore. When we get up there, it's go time and they need to be on our side.
Yeah, we go together instead of going separate.
We do not split up. They keep with us and they fight with us.
Agreed.
Does that sound fair? All right. Well, let's march on back. I'm going to keep Parallax out.
Okay. When you make it back to the lift, the whole of Clan Malarn is hanging out, having calmed back down after the initial panic of the start of the morning. They've finished their breakfast and are in the process of hanging out in the meantime while they wait.
So as we come around the corner and we all kind of get in the lift together, who's the girl that's done all the talking?
Jarena.
Okay, I'll look to Jarena and say, we never really got details, I don't think. How did you guys get through the firestorm in the first place?
Our carriages. We outfitted them for this trip.
Were they magical carriages? Like,
you saw this outside, for what it's worth.
What was, like, how were they outfitted? I don't remember.
They had a roof, basically, that went over top of the carriage and over top of the animals in front of it that was magically, like, a
alright.
Can I think of the right word? A liquid, sort of, that was fire resistant, basically, on top of it.
So if they were able to come up with that, then it could, it's not too crazy that they would come here to loot the place.
They figured out a way to get in, yeah.
And how many, oh, all right, that answered my question.
there they are.
So there's a lot of them.
There's 9.
And they're halflings, so that equals what, 4?
Four and a half. You guys are only 4.5, though. You've got Rev.
That's true. even split. But we have Puck that pushes us over. All right. Here's the deal. We have the password. I can only speak for myself. I don't know that I fully trust you as a group, but the rest of the team outvoted me. We can all go up together, but when we get up there, we are going to lead the way, as Bryn has a way to find the torch, and you all stick with us. Anything that we run into, we deal with together as a group. No more splitting up. No more splitting the reward, you know, before we get up there. Once we get up there, we deal with everything so that we all get what each of us came for. Agreed?
No. We already have a deal. Just because you have found one piece of the puzzle here doesn't give you leverage to suddenly renege.
And we fixed the entire lift and found the code to go up.
You fixed the lift while we removed the obstacle in the way of the water. Well, yes. We worked together. We each did something. Well, then you guys found the key. Great. Wonderful. That was part of the deal. You're reneging on this deal now?
No. We will still split the treasure, as we said. I didn't want to bring you up in the lift. The rest of the group thinks it's okay. But now, as we all go up together towards the
treasure...
Leave
some behind if it makes you feel more comfortable.
You're splitting hairs here, Drina. It's fine. We're doing it. But we are sticking together, all of us, as we go through the upper levels. And if we run into some kind of a fight, we're all going to fight together. And no Drina, you are acting as though you have any leverage in this at all. The lift only goes if we decide it goes.
And we don't go anywhere. We'll just stand here. Is that what you want? Why has this suddenly become a problem? This hasn't been a problem. We had a deal.
I think she's protesting a little bit too much.
I kind of agree.
We're worried that you're going to steal what you want from us.
Can you not see this from our perspective? Literally the same questions.
You know we're not here for just simple
why?
Trigger.
How do I know that? Because you said it? Great. I can speak words too.
You know we are sent from Simeon. That's where
I have decided to trust you. And if you don't return that, that is not my fault. There's no proof here that anything is going on beyond what you've told me.
Because we've risked our lives in this, while you haven't done a single bloody thing. That is
why. That you know of? Did you come out into the equestrian track? Did you see the knights that we killed? They exploded in blood. It was a great time for all of us. Brilfin still is burned from it.
Wait, if I look over, is he still burned?
He does have some singes on his armor that weren't there previously. Because we don't fight everything that stands in our path doesn't mean we're not doing anything.
That feels a bit pointed.
I did say earlier, you are so loud. Except for him, points to Rev. At least he can walk without clanging against the wall.
Hey.
Yeah. Speaking is not our strong suit.
Anyway, this is... I'm being rude. Apologies. That isn't what I'm trying to say. I don't see what's changed. We are both trusting each other here.
The higher up we go, the higher the stakes get. You understand that
we're the same from the beginning. We talked about the torch literally outside of this place.
No.
Yes, but now we can go up.
Not necessarily.
We can go up before.
When we go up that elevator, we're going to be dealing with an inquisitor, probably an undead inquisitor. So forgive us for being just a little bit more careful in how we
proceed.
You see me as working with an undead inquisitor? Is that what you're saying?
I see you working with somebody who might not be, let's just say, scrupulous.
Well, I am offended that you don't consider me scrupulous because we are working for me. I am the leader of this clan, this group. Whatever. That's fine.
Do I believe that?
You don't
that?
Have to trust me. I don't care. What only matters to me is that we made a deal and we continue on with it. That's it.
Do I believe what she said about them being not about them being scrupulous and not about them about her being the leader?
Are you trying to say, do you believe that she's actually the leader and that she's not serving someone else?
Yes.
Yeah.
Sure, go ahead and make an insight check. That's fine.
Well, the deal was that we would work together through this dungeon, this castle, and then when we found the treasure hoard, we'd split it 50-50, and we would get the torch. Or maybe it wasn't 50-50.
It was like 40-60.
It was like 40-60 or something like that. That can still happen without the rest of you coming up with us.
No. That does not seem like a smart decision. Would you say... Let's switch this a second. We have the code. And we say, oh, you guys can stay down here. We'll go get all the treasure and bring it back to you. That seems like a great move.
Whether you trust us or not, the reason that we're here is the torch. We're here to try to save lives. And the chance of you beating us to the torch and backstabbing us means potentially thousands or hundreds of thousands of people die. So your trust is not as valuable as that.
It is to me.
That's great.
That's how I think of yours, too.
What if we up your percentage?
I don't care. I don't... It's such a bad business decision to say, sure, you guys go get the treasure and bring it back to us. We trust you entirely to tell us exactly what you found, tell us what our cut is. It just is a stupid move. You have to admit that from my perspective, idiotic.
But also, with the amount of information that you've withheld, you've got to see from our side it's stupid as well.
You what did knew we withheld? That there was, the map?
You knew that there was this lift. You knew that there was a third, fourth, fifth level and didn't share that. You could have easily gone about and found the code if it wasn't blocked by skeletons and gone up there without us and taken everything.
Admit, that did cross my mind. Then we told you about it all. We showed you the map. We showed you everything about the entire place that we know.
Don't you have Zone of Truth?
I do. I don't have it prepared.
I only rolled a 12.
Just I thought you said you were ready.
I was ready with locate object. Let's go.
What I would say, Myetharia, is that she seems genuinely upset, mostly at the idea that suddenly... you guys are seemingly backing out on a previously agreed deal.
Yeah, which could be either conclusion. Yeah. I say let's go up.
So, we know that the storm is slowly closing from how we opened it, right?
The path that you previously took, yes, slowly. And your orb will only last for another couple of days.
Well, this lift doesn't leave without us, so we'll be right back.
We'll
kind of nod everyone out into the hall as Cassie drops her phone.
Again.
So let's all pop out in the hall and say, I'll say, well, I still think fighting them is not the worst option. I do have a spell that could hit all of them and set us up for a pretty solid combat.
I literally do not want to vote. I do not care. If someone started fighting them, I would fight them. If we decided to let them up, I would let them up. I do not. I cannot care. Like, it feels like the odds are either it is the biggest mistake that we've ever made in this game or the best thing we've ever done in our lives playing this game. Like,
that's really fair.
It is 0 to 100. Yeah. And if we want to play the game like the psychos, then yeah, like that we should, you know, like we could fight them, you know. If we play the games like psychos and we end up being right, like that would be the coolest thing we've ever fucking done. So that's why I'm just saying I'm not even gonna vote because it just doesn't. I don't know.
I feel like we've now. I don't want to fight. But I feel like we've shot ourselves in the foot by having to have this conversation and that they'll renege once we get up.
They'll get over it. If they're not going to just attack us anyway, they'll get over it. But if they're like already, like if Jack is right and they are going to double cross us, then it doesn't really matter we had this conversation to begin with.
Yeah, it doesn't. But the benefit is, if we fight now, then nobody gets up there without us. Whereas if we fight when we're up there and we lose, they get the torch.
Then we just chase them down and Justin has to plan more.
Let's game out though, like let's say they are allies or potential allies in the future. Like we have essentially barred us from what? Like, I mean that question honestly.
Right.
I don't really know what the potential downside of it, other than just be, we're just dicks. Like, we're suddenly the bad guys. We just killed or maimed or knocked out a bunch of people that were innocent, which is
we also don't have to kill them. That's the other thing is we could just fight them, knock them out, tie them up, and leave them down here. Pin them all down, stack them on top of each other, one immovable rod pressing them down. A halfling sandwich.
Yeah, that hasn't not worked in the past.
I guess I'm in kind of the same boat, but I mean, also if we were to fight them and knock them out, and like their connections with Simeon, right? Like they know they're from the Lyceum,
or at least that's what we saw them. We saw them after Gloriana, but But it sounds like they don't really have any kind of loyalties.
Also, there are a bunch of Tomb Raiders. Like, who could they be working for other than themselves that would do us any damage?
Unless they really are here for the torch and have been hired by somebody to get it.
Yeah.
And are just really good at looting.
It wouldn't. Let's just say it would hurt our reputation. It probably would get out.
Yeah, that's where I stand.
We've got a good reputation right now.
It would hurt our reputation until you had a conversation with us and we explained it, and they'd be like, oh, okay, that makes a lot of sense.
Oh, you guys were feeling paranoid and you killed these people? Great. Okay.
Right? Oh. That's totally worthwhile. You guys are feeling bad? Had some bad thoughts and just kind of murdered?
Yeah. Yeah, you just like...
That seems legit. I'm okay with that now.
I don't have any reasoning at all, but I think we should take the risk.
I think that
of bringing them up. Sorry.
Yeah, the conservative move would not to do anything until we had concrete reason to go to town on them.
Yeah, but
like we're essentially making this move just on a hunch.
But we're also we would also there... we'd also agree to bring them with us essentially to be nice to them. That's essentially what we're getting out of this. We don't gain anything beyond that.
I don't feel
potential ally down the way. I mean, they are... we already listed off the things that we... Like, our reputation and a potential ally.
And we made a deal with them.
We made a deal with them, yeah.
We made a deal.
Oh, and I'm 100% good with keeping up the deal. We can even keep the 40-60 split after we get the torch.
So the... For you, Jack is nicer than you. I feel like more Rob is coming out in this than Jack.
Well, I mean,
maybe. I don't know. Jack has changed a lot since Parallax.
Jack's changed a lot, and this is how my character is being played.
I'm literally working on the episode where Jack essentially murders Steph.
Saps the crap out of the hag.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
I don't trust them, but I say we go up and be on our guard and deal with any repercussions after we go up.
Okay.
Yeah. That's where I stand.
Yeah, you know what? I think that's where I'm at too. Because like at the end of the day, like, I don't know, maybe you're right. It like literally is a 50-50 chance. And it's like, until I see something concrete, you just kind of have to go with, you know, and
I feel like we've rolled poorly on every really insight high. Check on them.
I don't think we have them. We haven't. Like, I feel like we
remember.
I think we've had enough opportunities to like kind of suss out sort of something suspicious with them, other than they're in it for the money. Like, we definitely can tell they are sincere about wanting money.
Oh, and definitely,
That's, you know, it's not like no reason to go fighting them.
Right.
But that's, you know, that's the conservative option. The other option is to go ham. Let's have some fun. Why not? I don't really.
What's your
like? Point? I said I don't even want to vote. All
right, then I'm outvoted, so I'll go with what you guys say. But I still want to stick to what I said. Find, locate object, and we all stick together.
I don't think that.
We'll see what happens.
They don't want to stick with us. I think that's fine because that means
we don't know what happens when we get off the elevator either.
At least we're going in the right direction and they're not. If we have locate object up and it pings and we know we're going in the right direction, if they don't want to follow us, that's fine. Because that means at least we're getting to it first. I mean, they don't get any damage from anything guarding it, but...
That's a good point. Yeah.
Oh, you know, also, don't they have a cleric in their group?
Yeah. Without fail. Yeah.
They could probably just do the same thing.
Yeah, but then we'd be walking in the same path.
I say it's a risk worth taking.
So not even the locate object and all stick together?
I think we should do locate object. I think we should. That's smart.
But then he's saying them stick with us.
I don't care if they don't want to.
Well, it's a moot point, because once we go up there, they could just go, see ya, and walk away, and then our options are, do we fight him and kill him for not sticking with the deal, or do we let him go and we're in the same exact spot?
So the biggest thing then, that if we're going to bring them up, is if and when we see the torch, Winry, no matter what is going on, your first job is to get it. You can get there the fastest.
They grab the torch, follow them.
I mean, you are faster than all of them put together.
Longest. Yeah.
As long as they don't take the risk and teleport.
Would fall teleport. Yeah.
If they go,
I feel like you guys are making my argument for me. No, it's fine. We voted, and we're good to go. Oh, my computer's about to die too. All right, let's do it. Let's go. I got 10%. I'm fine. Right, Cassie? I got 10%. I'm fine.
Right. It's fine.
Totally fine.
It's fine.
All right. Let's go back.
I mean, we all understand that it would suck if, like, they betrayed us. Like, that's not...
But
we get that. That's the argument. But, like, we don't have literally any evidence that they're going to betray us. And, like, we're just saying, like, this on a hunch, which is fine. Like, hunches are great, and sometimes they're right. But, like...
It's fine. We voted. I'm going with what the group voted. I'm just saying, I've
got fairy fire for invisibility.
We're only going to have solid evidence when they grab the torch and teleport away. Then we'll know that we screwed up.
Okay. That's how it goes.
Late.
Then we'll find them.
Okay.
Yeah, that's how it goes.
Okay.
We go back and... Yeah, I mean, there's nothing to say. We go, okay, whatever, nothing changes. Oh. Let's go.
A couple hours to let the pressure finish building.
A couple hours?
It all went away?
It was like 2 seconds. No. It was open.
It was literally supposed to be a day's worth of time for it to fully recharge.
Does that mean we can take another long rest?
No, because you can't long rest twice within a 24-hour period. But you did take a short rest, but spending a little bit of extra time waiting, eventually the pressure has built fully, and there's a sound from the center of the lift, like a ding almost, that lets you know, and a light turns on, the lift is ready to go.
Can Myetharia and Reb do a little bit of, like, sparring and stuff while we wait?
Totally, sure.
Is there anybody on their side that looks like they are a decent spar?
So Grelfin is probably their most militaristic, so to speak. Their most fighty. He's the paladin. And then there's Aller, who would be kind of more similar to you as kind of like a rogue type individual.
What does Grelfin carry?
Like full armor and a shield and a sword.
A sword? Hey, you want to go with that sword?
Actually, he has a warhammer, sorry. A sword? But yeah.
You want to go with that hammer?
He kind of smiles, like, I like to think so.
Want to give it a go?
Perhaps. We could have some fun. As long as it's light. Don't want to be worn out before any potential fighting.
Just to, you know, keep us on our toes, you know? Help us out.
Have a little sparring session while you wait.
Does he seem good natured? Like, I'm going to try and, like, actually, you know, like, not...
Talk to him while it's going on, all this
stuff.
I'll
talk to him a little bit, but, like, just sort of, like, yeah, you swing that hammer pretty fast. That's nice. You know, stuff like just commenting on the, like...
Yeah, he isn't to the level of you guys, if that's what you're trying to gauge.
Yeah, exactly.
You guys are certainly more skilled fighters than they are. But he's not worthless either. He does wear full plate. He wields a shield and he has a warhammer that he uses. He's probably similar to, like, if you wanted to get gamey, he's like similar to like a level 6 to 8 PC, roughly.
Can I give him the impression that he's keeping up with me?
Sure. You're skilled enough that you can kind of slack a little bit and let it seem more even.
Okay.
I like it.
Good.
He's close enough that he, in theory, could win, if that makes sense. But it would take a pretty long set of rules.
Natural 20s.
Yeah. Okay. Cool.
Is there anybody who's like sitting and reading or like knitting or some little craft?
Anybody whittling?
So mostly there's four main people. There's Jarena, Grelfin, Aller, and Ernest are kind of the main ones. The other five are more, I don't want to call them grunts, but like they're
like
filler.
Yeah. The guy that we drank with in that one town once.
Right. They're kind of, no, not quite. But they're definitely lesser class, so to speak. They're there knowing that they don't have voting rights, so to speak.
I'm going to take my spot in line to do stuff. I'm going to go talk to Drina.
Okay. Well, we, I think, are very late. Unless you really wanted to keep doing this.
I would love to end it with us going up the elevator, so...
You would actually do it. I was going to start the next session with the descriptions, but I am good with ending with it here, if you'd rather.
It's up to you guys.
I guess I'll forget, so I'll just say briefly that I go up to Drina and I stab her in the face. No. I come in kind of like...
Blood. Sorry.
I guess I will de-summon Parallax, and I'll kind of like start off and be like, I don't know, just be kind of like, I don't know that I still trust you, but then I wanted to talk about like, take some chutzpah to be a tomb raider to go into a fire wreath place where two or three armies want to get to and steal all treasure. It's pretty impressive that you have that kind of follow through and that kind of chutzpah.
Listen,
and just,
I know,
like, chatter
up. I don't want to hold any grudges here. I understand that why you don't trust me or any of us. That makes sense. But as for coming here, all the best treasure is always hidden in the hardest places to get.
Makes a lot of sense. No risk, no reward. I actually was raised in a noble house, and I left there to pursue my own future, and it's been a pretty rough road so far, but I've kept at it. So I respect what you do.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
I'll pause it quick here.
That's it. I just wanted to smooth things over and make sure we're on the good page.
Yeah, everybody's all happy.
Yep. And then I'll play some music or something. That's it.
I was just kind of waiting because Ryan wanted to hear the description, but now he's distracted.
Well, I thought we would go up the elevator at the beginning of next session, is what I was saying. Not necessarily, because I just wanted to get through all the discussions with the
two. Yeah.
You're good.
That's what I was planning on doing.
Cool. Sorry, I didn't mean to.
Nope, you're fine. Okay. Well, with everything agreed, the lift fully pressurized now, the light on, so to speak, ready to go. We will end tonight's session here, and next time, we'll actually be heading up the lift this time.